Welcome once again to this online physics class for class 9. So we are doing the revision for this chapter, that is chapter number 10, gravitation. We have already started revising this chapter, and in the previous session I told you that I had given two sums, you all remember, and I told you all to solve that and see, and I said it will be explained in the upcoming sessions. So in today's session, first I am taking those two sums, I'll solve that and show, and then we'll proceed to a set of questions which are taken for revising. Okay, so now the first question is this: a force 20 newton acts on a body of weight 9.8 newton. Find the mass of the body whose acceleration due to gravity g is given as 9.8 meter per second square. This is standard value. So you have to find the mass of the body. See, the simplest way of doing this, using the formula W is equal to m into g, right? W means weight. Here in the question itself it is given as 9.8 newton, and mass we have to find. In the place of g, again it is 9.8 meter per second square. Your mass will be now 9.8 upon 9.8, which will give you 1 kg, because here also kilogram meter per second square, instead of newton you can apply that. And in the place of this 9.8, that is g value, it is meter per second square. So on either side it gets cancelled and kg will be left. So 1 kg is the answer. Hope it's clear now. Now, the next question. A stone resting on the ground has a gravitational force of 20 newton acting on it. What is the weight of the stone? So force, weight is also a kind of force acting towards the center, right? So in that case, if the gravitational force is given as 20 newton, the weight will also be 20 newton only. Clear to you? Okay, now let's move on to the next questions, which are in the form of multiple choice questions. The first question here: the falling of a body from a height towards the earth under the gravitational force of earth is called dash. The options are free fall, falling object, acceleration, gravity. See, the falling of a body from a height towards the earth under the gravitational force of earth. If it is falling under the influence of gravitational force of earth, we call it as what? Free fall. So the answer is option A, free fall. Now, the next question. If F is equal to M into A, then A will be what? If F is equal to M into A, simple. F is equal to M into A. So your A will be F upon M. So your option is A, right? So the answer would be option A, F upon M. There are many options given, but the correct option is option A, that is F upon M. Clear? Now, the next question. As we go up from the surface of the earth, the distance from the center of the earth increases, and hence value of g will increase or decrease, all will be equal or it will become zero. See, it's given clearly in the question. As we go up from the center of the earth, the distance from the center is increasing. Therefore, we have discussed when we were talking about the value of small g, above the surface of the earth, below the surface of the earth, at the center of the earth, you all remember? So when the object is away from the center of the earth, when it is going away from the center of the earth, up from the center of the earth, the distance is obviously increasing. Therefore, your acceleration due to gravity will decrease. Clear? The value of g will decrease. As we go up from the surface of the earth, the distance from the center of the earth is increasing. Hence, value of g will decrease. So the options given here are increases, decreases, equal and becomes zero. So the answer is option B, decreases. Next question. Acceleration due to gravity does not depend on the mass of a body. Yes, this we have discussed when I had taught the lesson to you. So acceleration due to gravity, that is your small g, does not depend on the mass of the falling body, right? G is equal to, you all remember that formula, g is equal to gm upon r square, right? Or d square. So this m is the mass of the earth. So value of small g does not depend on the mass of the body. Okay, now next question. When a body is falling vertically downwards, its velocity is increasing. Is it true or false? Whenever an object is falling downwards, its velocity will obviously increase. So the answer is true. Okay, now next question. The mass of a body is constant and does not change from place to place. Is it true or false? We have done this when we were doing that mass and weight. The mass remains the same. It is a quantity of matter contained in an object. So wherever the object is placed, the mass remains the same, but its weight will change because acceleration due to gravity keeps changing. Mass never changes. It's a quantity of matter contained in an object. So the mass of a body remains constant and it does not change from place to place is a true statement. Now, the weight of an object on the moon will be about dash of what it is on the earth. You all remember this, we had done when I had started with the numericals. The weight of an object on the moon will be about 1/6 of what it is on the earth. So there are four options given here: 1/6, 1/4, 1/3, half. The correct answer is option A, that is 1/6. So the weight of an object on the moon will be about 1/6 of what it is on the earth. Now, the next question. If the mass of a body is 5 kg, its weight would be what? Options given are 49 newton, 94 newton, 5 newton, 49 kg. See, 49 kg will not come because weight will not have that unit at all. The unit of weight here is newton, right? So among that A, B, C, we have to find out the correct one. See, the mass of the body is given as 5 kg. So what will be its weight? So which formula you have to apply? Weight they are asking. So W is equal to M into G. Okay. So W we have to find 5 into 9.8 is the value of small g. When you multiply this, 5 weights of 40 carry 4, 49, right? 9.8 multiplied by 5. 9.8 multiplied by 5 will give you 8 5s are 40, 4. 9 5s are 45 plus 4, 49, one decimal place. So 49 newton is the correct answer. That is option A. Clear to you? So with this, we are coming to an end of today's session. In the next session, I'll take a few more revision questions in the form of question answers. So this is the only lesson that you have from physics for your upcoming periodic test. That is periodic test number 2. So you have ample time to revise. Please revise. Again and again I'm telling you, please read your textbook thoroughly. Okay? So till we meet in the next class, take care. Bye and have a nice day.